Hi. So whilst the EO SwimBETTER tech has been built for elite athletes, and by that I mean it's the core of what we do is how do we help elite athletes perform better. It's amazing how relevant it is for non-elite athletes and people such as myself. So where we've got guys like Kyle Chalmers, who missed out on gold in Tokyo. He won the gold in Brazil, in Rio, in the 100 metres, and then missed out to Caleb Dressel in Tokyo by 0.06 of a second. So whilst we're working closely with guys like Kyle as to how they can find not just that 0.06, but more to hopefully go one better in Paris this year, it's remarkable how insightful the system can be for people like me. So I want to show you some interesting data from a lady that I occasionally have some contact with in the United States, who's an amazing woman and at a later stage in life has decided to become a triathlete. And the most challenging area, of course, is her swim. And I wanted to just go through a couple of things with her data just to show you not only what the data is giving us, but explain exactly why. And it might get a little bit technical, but I'll try and explain it in very simple terms. So forgive me if you've heard this before, but I need to go through this because this sets up the explanation for why we're seeing what we're seeing. Inside the O is the pressure sensor in here that measures the force that we push through the palm of our hand. We know that as we go deeper in water, we experience hydrostatic water pressure, so natural pressure that gets built up from water. And so as we move our hand deeper, there's forces being contributed to by the movement of my hand, plus there are forces being contributed to by the depth. And we need to isolate the forces in my hand. And the way we do that is by having a second sensor on the edge of the handset right here. And in very, very simple terms, if you can imagine, as my hand moves through that water, the amount of force that's being applied on my hand is that force minus that force. That's really important. So the primary purpose of this, not the sole purpose, but the primary purpose of this is to measure what forces are at work as my hand goes deeper. And then we deduct those from the total forces here to end up with the net forces coming from the hand. The reason I explain that is because if at a certain point in your swim, if you are generating lower force through here than here, because remember, the net force is that minus that. Well, if you're generating less here than you are here, then you're going to end up with a negative force. Now, this is different to hand drag. With hand drag, we know that as the hand comes in, if we push the hand like this, we experience a negative propulsion. That's clear. But when during the stroke, if the hand moves in a particular way so that we're getting minimal force on the palm of the hand, but considerable force moving with the edge of the hand, we'll go negative. And the reason I want to bring this up is because when we look at, let's have a look at some of this data here, and you'll see some of these strokes in the middle of a stroke, this left hand here in the middle of it, we'll turn the right off. Let's look at some of these. This left-hand stroke here, in the middle of the propulsive stroke, we're going negative. Likewise, this one, likewise, this one. We know we've talked about double peaks before, where the propulsion comes off, but this propulsion is going off so far that it's going negative. So immediately we see, hang on, there's something weird happening in the middle of this stroke. Let's work out what it is. So I'm going to go back to here, and we're going to count which stroke it is. Now, these first ones, they're the breakout strokes, so we don't count those strokes, they're not strokes. This is right stroke one, left stroke one, left stroke two, left stroke three. So when we go to our stroke path and force, and we look at left stroke three, here we are, we're going negative. Let's look at the overhead, and let's look at the lateral. And so here we can see these huge moves in the lateral forces here, where we're going lateral in inside left, moving inwards, and then it's backing off and it's going positive and then it's going negative again. So it's funny, it's like a mirror of the propulsive forces. So, and as we move through here, you'll see the left hand here moving in, and as it's moving in, we're also generating that inward force. But right here is where we start, that left hand starts to move out. Now, if that left hand was moving out facing the back, we wouldn't be getting this sort of activity going on. So what's happening here is whilst that left hand is moving out, it's also rotated like that. And so as it's moving there, that hand is rotated so that it's generating more force through the edge than it is through the palm. There's still a little bit of force being generated through the palm, but considerably more through the side sensor. And that is causing this point right here. At that point, we're generating slightly more force here than we are through here, which means that we're not generating any propulsion, which means that our propulsion has gone off the cliff. And you can see exactly where that hand is in the hand position and how that hand is moving outwards, and it's slicing through the water. So what this swimmer needs to do is to make sure that that hand, as it's moving out, moves out and continues to face the back and doesn't allow it to roll. And it's that rolling that's minimizing the force on the palm of the hand, increasing the force on the edge of the hand, so that that force minus that force sends it negative. We'll have a look at a couple more. Exactly the same story here. You can see as we come out, and then as it moves in, again, right at this point here, where we're hitting the peak negative, you'll see that left hand is coming out. Let's see what we can see on the right hand. Right hand is quite informative as well. You'll see as we come through here, that right hand has got this big move inwards. And as that's moving inwards here, it's generating this negative force. And then it gets to here. And then now you can see here, it's going to move outwards. And again, as it moves outwards, it's going to generate positive lateral force because it's facing that way. And it's going to generate more, force on the side sensor than it is on the palm. In fact, let's have a quick squeeze here. Because if we go to the head on, and this is where it gets just a little bit tricky, because you've got to sort of visualize what this hand is doing. So I'll bring it back up to the entry. So you can see the entry as it, and we're watching in here. You'll see the entry as it comes in, and then it moves inwards. And then at this maximum point of inwards, right, just come back to the overhead, right here, and it's now going to come sweep back out. Go back to the head on. It's going to now sweep back out. As it sweeps out, right here, and you'll see this is where we're losing propulsion. And not only do we lose it, we go negative in propulsion. Turn that off. Excuse me, we go negative in propulsion here. And that's going negative in propulsion because that's moving sideways. You can see that sideways move. As it's moving sideways, it's generating more force here than it is here. That hand in that sideways move is cutting like that. The hand isn't generating the propulsion that it should be generating. Hence, the propulsion falls off the cliff and we generate negative propulsion at this point. Then exits the water here, and as you can see, goes into recovery. So hopefully that helps explain a couple of things. Hopefully it shows you exactly how you can diagnose some weird sideways or lateral movements that are going on that result in this sort of activity happening, this sort of negative propulsion that's being generated. You can see it's the same story here. Here is where we hit that point of inward maximum point inwards, and then when we're going to start to move outwards back to the head on, and you can see how that lateral move right there on the hand, how it's moving sideways, results in that negative force in the middle of propulsion. Hope this helps. We'll keep sending you little tidbits and little insights into data as we go. Keep it up. Thanks.